Now with the second sum, this is a statement sum. So the question, look here, it says, it speaks about volleyball games played by N teams. The question is, how many teams are there in the league? Okay, so given number of teams equal to N. So the league has got what? N teams. So given number of teams as N. And each team plays with every other team exactly once, and the league schedule is 15 games. So total number of games is called G of N is equal to 15. So this and this both are given, and this is also given, Gn equal to N square minus N minus 2, this is also given. So number of teams is N, number of games is totally what? 15 games, 2, and last one is Gn equal to N square minus N, that you must put as 15. This is kept in the left hand side, this is you take it as right hand side. So remember, generally unknown letters are simultaneous or a quadratic or a linear equation. We just retain the unknown letters in the left hand side and make it ulta, you put this 15. Now this 2 will go and multiply this. So you get N square minus N minus 30 equal to 0. So till this is nothing but part 1. So I repeat it, part 1. They are given how many teams are in the league, they asked. So, and they are given there are N teams. So given number of teams equal to, you must keep it as N, because they themselves are given as N teams are playing. And totally there are 15 games played by the league. So total number of games, G of N equal to 15, you can keep it. And they are given the equation G of N equal to N square minus N minus 2. So in the place of G and N, you must put 15 equal to N squared by N minus 2. And I told you, unknown letters are kept in the left hand side and number you keep in the right hand side, whether it's simultaneous or quadratic or linear. And then this 2 will multiply, so you get N square minus N minus 30. Now this is part 2, where now you have to split the quadratic equation. The number is actually 30, minus 30, and this is minus 1N. This is a middle term. I told you it's also called splitting the middle term. So minus 1 you put here, and 30 into 1. 31 is a minus 30. I told you, don't put the sign. You just hide this number. Take this 30. See, 30, you can find the factors. For example, the factors are 10 into 3, 30. Suppose you get this. Add and see, subtract and see. 10 plus 3 is 13, 10 minus 3 is 7. Both are not tallying. So take this number, don't take any signs. Just find the factors of 13. 10 into 3 is not coming. So next, you can take this 6 into 5. 6 into 5, you get us what? 30. 6 plus 5 is 11. 6 minus 5 is 1. You're getting this 1. So don't worry about the sign first. First you find the factors. Add and see, subtract and see which is tallying it. Now what you do is actually, you put the 6 and 5. So see, look here, I didn't put any sign. You put the 6 and 5. 6 5s are 30. 6 minus 5 is 1. Now to put the sign, always you hide this. So this will be minus 6 plus 5. You can check it. Now we must tally the three things. 6 5s are what? Number 1 is, you must tally the 6 into 5 is what? 30. Number 2 is plus into minus. Plus into minus equal to this minus. Plus into minus equal to minus. So this is plus and this is minus. Plus into minus equal to minus. This minus. 6 5s are this 30. And when you add, this is tallying. When all three are tallied, you must start splitting it. So this we saw last time also, this is actually splitting the middle term, where you take the 30 and find the factors, add and see and subtract and see which is tallying, you put the numbers and then put the signs, and then tally everything satisfied. Now write the N square as it is, write the minus 30 as it is. So the middle term you are splitting, minus 6N and plus 5N. Okay, that's what we have done it. And then group these two terms. n is common. When you take out n, you get n into n is n square, n into minus 6 is minus 6. Plus 5 is common, again you get n minus 6. So this n minus 6 factor is common. So take this n minus 6, then you get this n and you get this 5. So n minus 6 into n plus 5 equal to 0. So this is called an expression I told you. This is called the factorized form of the same expression. In fact, if you multiply x1, you get this answer. Now you split the terms. So two numbers should be 0 means either this should be 0 or this should be 0. So n minus 6 should be 0 or n plus 5 should be 0. When n minus 6 is 0, n is equal to 6 or n equal to minus 5. N cannot be negative. Number of teams cannot be minus 5 and all. So n should be positive. Therefore, number of teams equal to 6. Hope you understood this problem.